Hey guys, today I have an unusual video for you. I'll do a tour of my apartment. I live in Montreal and rents are pretty high, I'd say. Not as much as LA, New York or Toronto though, but still, to give you an idea, most average apartments in somewhat nice areas will cost you around 1k per month, and if you want a really nice apartment with 2 bedrooms, you'll get closer to 2k a month. However, my girlfriend and I have decided to live a bit more frugally for the last 2 years without compromising too much, so I thought it'd be nice to show you how we do it. And as this is a tech channel mainly, I will still show you how I was able to suit my tech enthusiast desires in this apartment. And I'll have links to all the tech that I'll feature in the following in the description. And I'm making this video because we're moving next summer, so the clock is ticking for that video idea. And it's not to brag or anything, there's really not a lot to brag about anyway. Really just maybe to inspire you a bit if you plan on moving to a bigger city and don't want to spend too much. So here we go. So we live in an older building that was supposedly built in the 1930s and it's located in the Villemort neighborhood. It's not a particularly praised area of Montreal, but we chose that spot to save on rent, as we currently pay $765 per month for a 700 square foot apartment with 1 bedroom, and it was partially renovated in 2015. Also, it's not too far from public transports. In fact, there's a subway station about 5 minutes away from our apartment, so that we can easily go downtown when we want. As we both work downtown, that was a deciding factor. Our daily commute to work takes us around 30 minutes, so that's not too bad considering how far we live. We'll start with the living room, which is where most of the tech is. One thing to note is the high ceilings, which we like a lot. That's also where my girlfriend and I spend the most of our time when we're home. There's our TV, which is a 55-inch Vizio M-Series TV. It was one of the best TVs for the price when we bought it 1 year ago, and we like it a lot. The picture quality is really good, and the built-in 4K Chromecast is a nice addition too. It's mounted on the wall for a cleaner look, and the cables are hidden with an IKEA Raceway. We use this Kanto SYD speaker as a soundbar and it's really great for that. I got that speaker in exchange for a video review and it was nice to put it to use there. Under it is our media unit. This one is from a local furniture maker called De Gaspé and it's actually made in Montreal. These are really expensive and we got this one for about 90% off because it was a demo unit, so such a great deal for high quality furniture. We only use the TV for Netflix as we don't have a cable subscription, so we save a bit there. Same thing for our internet, we have a pretty basic package of 25 down and 10 up with unlimited transfer, and that's quite slow for nowadays standards, but it's just enough for our needs and we can stream Netflix's 4K content with that too. The really good point of that package is that I was able to get it for $25 per month and that was a 50% rebate for 1 year, so that's mainly why we stick with it. But at our next place, I will go with a plan that has better download and upload speeds for sure. There's also our couch. It's quite small, just enough for the both of us, and it's really heavy, made in Canada furniture, so it should last us a while, and that's what we wanted. Right now, it has a cover that my girlfriend made to protect it, but normally it's light gray. Next to it is my desk setup. Again, a lot of it has been given to me by companies for videos on my channel, like the sit-stand legs, the monitor, and the speakers. But still, apart from the monitor, most of these items aren't too expensive. This desk lamp is a local creation I found on Etsy with a LifeX bulb installed, and the desktop is from IKEA but I stained it myself. The speakers are also paired with a matching sub under the desk. It's not ideal to have a sub installed like this, but it's much easier to clean under my desk that way. Finally, two LifeX LED strips are also installed, one under the desk and one under the monitor, and it adds just enough ambient light. On the other side of the room is an old closet. The owner of the building wanted us to keep it as is, but we didn't like the color and style, so we use curtains to hide it from sight when we don't use it. Next to it is my girlfriend's sewing desk. It's actually a previous sit-stand desk of mine that was given in exchange for a video review, again, and same thing for that nice BenQ lamp. Finally, that room is filled with LifeX lights, so I can easily set a mood with my phone, and these are quite expensive and it took me a while to get all of them, and I also waited for sales or reviewer rebates to order some of them. And that wraps it up for the living room. The dining room is pretty simple. We have a wooden table, two chairs and a bench. The table is made by a guy in Montreal, which unfortunately doesn't make them anymore. And again, it was super affordable at around 200 bucks. We also bought this hot water dispenser as we like hot beverages a lot. It's super high quality, made in Japan, and these are supposed to last decades. And again, we bought it used, so we save a lot compared to a new one. The dining room is also where we enter the apartment, and we have a coat rack and crates on the wall to store everyday carry items. These are all from IKEA, and the quality is alright overall. The crates had a natural wood finish initially, but I stained them using the remaining stain that I had for my desk. One thing that our new place has is an entrance closet, and that's really something we wanted, as we don't really like to have all our outdoor clothes on site. But it's a great alternative for the apartment we're in now. Now to the bedroom. This is a really small room. We have a queen size bed and it barely fits. You can see two nightstands, and these are also from IKEA, and we painted them using the remaining white paint we had for the apartment's walls and the stain that I had left, again from my desk tabletop. We also had a plant, but it wasn't getting enough sunlight, so we placed it in the kitchen. And the mirror doors are our closet space, with all my clothes fitting on a single pole. I try to keep my wardrobe small with pieces that are basic, and that's how I can fit it in a smaller section. And finally, we also have two LifeX bulbs as ceiling lights, so we can set the colors we want from our phones. I'd love to have smart thermostats too, but I'll wait for our next place to invest further in smart home tech. Now we'll head to the kitchen. That's a really small kitchen and not a lot of counter space, and quite crowded with the washing machine and dryer. We don't have a dishwasher either, but we're used to doing the dishes, so it doesn't feel like too big of a chore. This place and the bathroom were the renovated areas of the apartment, and those really make a big difference in how the apartment looks, I think. An old kitchen and bathroom can easily look dirty. The part that we like the most though is our automatic coffee machine. It's not really a tech item, but it does serve us a lot. It's always nice to brew a fresh cup of coffee in the morning with that small appliance. Again, we got it a little over a year ago as a refurbished model, and that was worth it up to now as it still works great. But it does require a bit of maintenance though. We don't have a microwave either, not that we don't want to, but it would take too much space and we can easily live without one at home. So it's fine for us. And finally, the bathroom. Nothing really exciting here, apart that it's small and has very little storage. We had to add this shelving unit here to help, but we'd prefer to have a slightly large counter section with more storage room. And again, no tech in there really. Now, that apartment is far from perfect. The main pros are that it was partially renovated recently, and it's a decent size considering the price we pay, but going with an older building has its problems too. First, the floor is crooked as hell in most rooms. There's a good 2-degree angle at some places, and that's quite irritating that none of our furniture is leveled. And if you have office chairs, they tend to roll around too. Then the isolation is subpar both in sound and temperature, so the floors are cold during the winter and summers are hot even with a decent AC. And finally, divisions have changed since its construction to make it more open-spaced, but there's not a lot of natural light as you only have windows at the front and at the back of the building, but that's common in Montreal even with some of the newer buildings. So that wraps it up for this video. Let me know down below if you liked it or not. I know it's quite different from what I usually do on this channel, so I'd understand if that didn't interest some of you. And if you did enjoy, I'd be more than happy to make a similar video at our new place. Here's a sneak peek of what it looks like. Definitely an upgrade compared to where we are now. So that could be interesting. So hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you like the video if you did, and if you didn't, just let me know why in the comments below. Otherwise, don't forget to subscribe if you still haven't already, as I'll see you in the next video.